10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today I've been working on the Spitfire because I've had a couple of problems, just like a lot of other people seem to have. Had a broken aileron cable and part 8106, this is the threaded nut for the riser. As you know, the shaft screws in there. Basically I had to glue the threaded nut because it came out. This plastic base split, I'll quickly show you. Here we go, let's see if we can get this in focus. There we go. It's a bit discoloured, that's probably due to the super glue, but you can just see at one end there's a tiny little crack. There you go. Clearly see it now. Now that split, not just at that point, but all the way down. So the basically that brass threaded nut, it came out. And the riser just stopped working, and the plane was just like listed over to one side. Thankfully it didn't break anything else, so I've replaced that today and everything seems to be fine with it. This one obviously is glued in, so you'd like to think it's permanent, but I've replaced it anyway. As for the rest of it, it seemed fine. The riser, obviously, because I've had it in and out. Some of the plastic threads for the screws were a little bit loose on one or two of them, so I've replaced virtually everything on that riser. I think the only thing I didn't replace was the actual switches, the limit switches, but the cogs, the shaft, everything has been replaced, so hopefully that won't give me any more problems. Now the other thing was the cable. I'll show you this. Here we have the cable. If I can find, there we are. If you look at the end where the cog is, you'll see there's a dirt patch right in the middle up to the cog. Now there should be a tab there. Now that tab broke off, and it basically limits the motor going one way then the other, and it basically tells the motor, right, I've come to the end, it's time to stop. But once that comes off, the motor just stops at one end. The aileron gets stuck and it can't come back whatsoever. So that is what I replaced. Now I can show you on here. There we go, show you on here. Now you can see the cable there, and you can just about see the tab, which is here, just there, in the screwdriver. That is what broke off. Now obviously I had to take the flap off with the hinges, and this second piece here, this second piece of the flap, and the housing around here, the cockpit. Okay, now here we have the plane, here we have the cable. It's inside the aileron here, so it basically goes that way in, so you don't need to replace the aileron because it just slips in. And then obviously you can see the tube sits there, so you have to remove the flap, this little piece as well, screw there, the two hinges, this one and this one, and obviously the cockpit. Also, here's the motor, and you can actually see there where the tab is, right in the middle. So you have to take the motor off, and this housing here, just unscrew this. There's one, two screws here, two screws on the other side, take off. So it probably take about 10 minutes, to be honest, but just take your time. taking these screws out. You don't want to over thread it, take the plastic out. It didn't take that long, to be honest. Just remember to put these flaps back in correctly, because this flap is, there's a tab here that sits in here, it inserts into there, so you must make sure that is correct as well. But it's working fine now, which is brilliant. It's just a pity I've got another problem, and that other problem is the landing gear motor. Here we have the landing gear motor. I'll show you what the problem is with this. There we go, there's the landing gear motor, all those lovely little cogs in front there, all here. There we go, it's focused back in again. Basically, the motor does rotate, but it can't take the load. You see it sometimes tugging at this cable, but there's nothing wrong with the cable, there's nothing wrong with the gears. I've replaced the nylon ones with the metal ones and vice versa, but it's the actually the motor. I don't know whether it's these cogs, but something's not right within all that configuration. And basically it's just not taking the load, so I've ordered a new motor, but they're out of stock. That's the only thing I've got left to replace now. As you can see, the Spitfire itself is nowhere near done. It won't take long to put all the panelling on and all the aerials on, but it's just a little sad that it's come to this with so many problems. Hopefully it'll get sorted pretty quickly before my subscription is actually finished. I hope so anyway, but I certainly won't be flogging it to death anymore. Probably run it once or twice a week, and as long as it keeps working, I'll be happy. But when I did speak to Hachette, they did say to me once the subscription's finished and when I had any further problems, I could contact them and they will replace the issues. So they know there's a massive problem here, which is sad because it's a fantastic looking plane. But anyway, I hope that is going to be helpful for anybody. If you do need any advice where the Spitfire is concerned and any problems, just give us a bell, leave us a message, leave a comment, and I'll get back to you. But anyway, thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye for now.